At the end of the 60s, the history of foreign immigration in Italy underwent a process of progressive and intense transformation. In the second half of the 60s, something new happened. Immigration flows began, essentially linked to male and female workers coming from the areas that we can define as border areas, who began to arrive in Italy with the aim of working in specific occupational sectors. These flows are of decisive importance, as they contribute to redrawing the geography of international migration. Italy finds itself representing, in a much more coherent way than in the past, an area that exerts a growing attraction towards the mobility of populations, especially from the point of view of work, or rather some specific jobs that foreign immigrants are beginning to carry out. One of the Italian geographical areas in which this process is particularly visible is the area of Trapani, Sicily, and one of the occupational contexts in which this transformation is maturing rapidly is the fishing sector, in particular work on the fishing fleets based in the port of Mazara del Vallo. The workers arrived from Tunisia and began to arrive between in 1968 and 1972 in Mazara, at a rate of 60-80 people per week. Initially, they stayed mainly in Mazara area to work in the fishing sector, but within a few years, they also moved to other Sicilian areas, mainly to seek work in the agricultural sector. The Trapani and Tunisian coasts were not unfamiliar with commercial and cultural exchanges even before the end of the 60s, but the movement towards the fishing sector generated a new migration season. The organization of such constant and specialized recruitment stemmed from the interest of Mozart Shing Powers in widening the pool of origin of their workforce following the crisis of the fishing industry, which in Mazara, as in other Italian ports, was already particularly visible in the mid-60s. In order to contextualize the penetration of immigration into the fishing sector, it is necessary to quickly outline the situation of the sector in the years between 60 and 70s. Throughout the internationalization of fishing, Italy intended to obtain a two-fold advantage. On one hand, to extend the sector potential by expanding its markets, and on other hand, to boost its political presence in Mediterranean area, in the context of cooperation with Arab countries. The fisheries agreements signed by Italy with other countries, not only Tunisia, underwent a turning point in the 70s, when the commitment of Italian governments became more pressing in order to guarantee an international expansion of the opportunities provided by the sector. Looking at the origins of the flow, we can point out that initially the movements towards Trapani and Mazara del Vallo came from the coastal area of Tunisia, but with the intensification on the demand for labor, they extended to the inland area of the Tunisia, involving a workforce less experienced in fishing. The spread of North African immigration in Trapani area has a number of characteristics that make it a paradigmatic case. The first Tunisians arrived on tourist visas without the work authorization and were generally employed without a contract. In order to contextualize the first arrivals in Sicily, we need to look at the Tunisian situation. The first Tunisian migratory contingents of numerical consistency left in three different directions. The first went towards France, the second towards Libya, and the third towards Algeria. However, the majority flow is toward France, which is based on agreements on the transfer of labor that established the condition of employment and residence. The Tunisians who begin to arrive in Italy follow two directions, one by routes that interest the center of the country and the south of the country, the other by the routes that interest the center and the north of the country. In order to reconstruct the history of immigration in Sicily and in Mazara, we can use the material published in 1979 in a census investigation, national investigation on immigration. The condition of isolation of immigrants, their professional placement in sector that the census defined as less guaranteed, and their scarce participation in trade union structures determined that the fact the perception of the dimensions and characteristics of the phenomenon is completely approximate, insofar as it is linked on the one hand to official data record, not even explicitly, only regular immigration. And on the other hand, the impressionistic normic systems that, upon initial verification, seem equally unfounded. This is a problem on this first phase of immigration in Italy and generally in Mediterranean Europe. The census research also contains a section dedicated to seafarers in the fishing sector, recruited in Tunisia by ship from Mazara. The paragraph dedicated to them opens with a very harsh description of their working condition. The section on fishing closes in this census investigation with a description of the mobility of Tunisians, a mobility that could be defined as multi-level, between one job and another job, but also between one area of the country and another area of the country. Fishing, for most of them, represented only one of the possible occupations in the Dramadi area during the 70s. The history of the Tunisians in the Trapani area from the end of the 60s is, in conclusion, an essential reference point for all those who intend to deal with the development of immigration in Italy from a historical perspective. We are faced with the beginning of a migratory current that then underwent further and multiple developments. At the same time, this flow developed taking root in an area, Western Sicily, that in the same historical phase was the protagonist of other migratory movements, mainly outgoing, both from Sicily and Italy. Immigration, internal migration, and return migration is in the same period, are in the same period. This is a typical feature, starting from the 60s, of many social and economic contexts in the Mediterranean area. But the elements of interest do not stop here. There are other three points that we can that we can do in the active recruiting of labor carried out by the Shin powers of Mazara, and this recruitment is a part of a conscious choice, even though it took place within a legal framework that lacked an inorganic framework. Until 1986, Italy had no specific legislation on immigration and foreign labor. The second, it is an insertion in the labor market and in the society that has led to the multiple forms of conflict and multiple forms of integration. Third, It has represented an element of recomposition in the Italian-Tunisian relations and more generally in the Italian economic and political projection on the Mediterranean. Thank you.